dancing Saturday night BBC One.
Shall we get my next guest out, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes!
Before we do, let's have a look at her in action. Here she is, pulling up to the bumper. Please welcome the incredible Grace Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Here she is.
Oh, here she comes.
Here she comes.
Watch out, boy, she'll chew you up. Oh, here she comes. Watch out, she's a man-eater. Oh, here she comes.
Happy to have you here. At last.
Finally.
Finally, I can't.
See you again.
Come. Madame. Grace Jones. Wow, that's amazing. Now, you see, I don't know what you're talking about. You say you didn't have your clothes with you. That's a fantastic outfit. Was that what you were wearing? That's day wear. You were wearing that anyway.
No, I was wearing, like, a bathrobe kimono kind of thing.
I see.
Yes, and the kind of outfit that I make up in, so it might have little patches and powder and stuff on it.
But you look great. Doesn't she look incredible, ladies and gentlemen? Grace Jones.
Thank you.
Wow, how lovely to have you here. Hey, you know, the thing is, I'm not just saying this, you don't appear to have aged in the last 30 years or so.
Well,
what's the secret? What have you been... You just been eating blueberries all the time or something?
No, I hate blueberries. Oh,
I'm sorry, I mentioned them.
I think red wine is a very good thing.
No.
So the doctors told me,
You're on the red wine diet?
Yeah.
So I suppose the grapes...
Not too much.
The grapes count as one of your
good.
Five a day, don't they, in the red wine?
Actually, my nickname is Grapes.
Is it? I won't ask why.
No, but I work out. I do. I
do.
I swim every day.
How far do you swim?
Almost every day.
It's a big swim, a long time.
Well, I try to do at least a half an hour without stopping. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And I like bicycling, especially in the English side, countryside.
How nice, how nice.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
I should imagine you don't dress up, you know, in the proper Grace Jones outfit for the cycling, because if we saw you coming down the road like that...
No, I do, actually. I've got an amazing outfit for cycling.
Have you really?
Yes. It's, you know, it's a Miyake. I love Miyake. So,
you wear Izzy Miyake when you're cycling?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Will you please tell me next
time
you're going
out,
I'm just going to come and hang around the corner and watch?
Actually, I'll give you one of the outfits. I have two.
I've got a watch, an outfit. I can't believe I'm left alone. You know, one of the things I love about you, I love various albums you've made over the years that I've grown up listening to and I've just enjoyed so much. I was playing, you know, those albums you made with Sly and Robbie were just tremendous. But I love the way that you seem to inspire others to create art. You're something of a muse to various people, aren't you, over the years? You've worked with so many great artists.
I like to think so. I love collaborating. And I like also for... When I collaborate, they push me and I push them. So you end up always with something magical in the end.
Something unique. And so you argue, you fight, you throw in your own ideas and...
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I've got tons of my own ideas.
I bet you have. Yeah. Was that, this photograph here of you, was that Jean-Paul Goude? Was that one of those?
Oh, my goodness.
That's a great photograph.
Yes,
isn't it?
It was Jean-Paul.
Yeah.
Yes.
How important is that part of, when you were recording and making music, how important is the visual side of it and the kind of image of the album covers and the look you're creating? Is that...
No, it's all very important for me because actually I really started on the stage as a teenager. And then my mother was very much into fashion. She was a seamstress, did weddings and things like that, and embroidered and crocheted. And we were all brought up doing that, learning how to do that. So that was very important for me. And I think growing up in Jamaica with a very religious background made my imagination even so much more out there, out of the box.
Why was that? Because of the colour of the religion you were feeding, or was it the fact that you wanted to break out of it?
No, it wasn't the colour, it's just that I realised I was living in a bubble. And there was not much going on except for, you know, school, which was in church, and church, and school, which was in church and school.
And how did young Grace rebel against that? What age did you start pushing against that?
As soon as, I think I pushed at it in a hidden way. where they didn't actually realize I was actually doing it in my own quiet way. And as soon as everyone would come home or see them coming home from climbing a tree, you know, looking down the road, then I'd take off my nail polish, you know, and I'd do all the things that vanity. I have a lot of vanity.
How did your mum react when you started changing, when you started rebelling against it? How did she deal with it?
Well, you know, marry a preacher, you know, like she did. And that's why one of the songs is called William's Blood in Me on the new album. And that all has to do about my mom trying to get me to do what she did. Otherwise, you know, you're going to be manizing and drinking and you're going to live a short life, you know.
Which is two out of those three you've been doing, I guess. Is that... because you have... You